can headaches be caused by iron deficiency? I got a story for you. So about 1 year ago, I had a 16-year-old female patient who had been having intense frontal headaches, headaches right here, almost daily for about 3 years, basically since she started menstruating. And she'd been all over the place, seeing different doctors, different specialists, you know, looking for answers. What is going on here? And essentially nobody had anything to offer her but pain medications or birth control. You know, she took ibuprofen and Tylenol almost daily. And sometimes even a couple times a day she'd be taking it because these just, they wouldn't go away. And you know, it's crazy to think a person having a headache literally almost every single day. How terrible would that be? You know, during all these visits, she said nobody actually drew her blood. Nobody did labs on her. They never looked at her labs. Isn't that crazy? So, of course, after getting a nice history from her, the first thing I did was draw some blood. Because the first thing that comes to my mind when a patient says they have a frontal headache, they're 16 years old, they're female, they're menstruating, is that they're probably iron deficient. Because that headache that's right between the eyes and right above the eyes, really mean iron deficiency or potentially B12 deficiency. Those are the main nutrients associated with that. So of course, you know, I was shocked when she was telling me in over 3 years of going to see different doctors and specialists that nobody drew her blood. She even got a brain MRI actually, but nobody drew her blood. Nobody checked her B12. Nobody checked her ferritin levels. Did a CBC on her. Looked at you know, what her iron, what her transferrin levels are. None of this. So I checked her levels. And sure enough, her ferritin was a 4. 4. I mean, that's like, bam, money right there. So we like to see ferritin levels to be at least around 50. And in some cases, you know, 70, 75, even up to 120 in some athletes, of course. Some patients need that, you know, for symptom relief. And I had one girl who needed her ferritin around 120 or her hair would keep falling out. So everything else in her blood work looked awesome. And so we immediately just started her on 2 capsules of Blood Vitality, an iron supplement, a special iron supplement, daily. And literally in a matter of about 2 weeks, her headaches were gone, completely gone. In 3 years of suffering, just like that, gone by getting her iron levels up. You know, she'd been told it's her hormones, she needs birth control, that's the only thing that's gonna help her, which she did try birth control and that didn't help her. But 2 weeks of getting a very, very well-known, you know, billions of people on the planet are deficient in nutrient up, and she was good to go. So, yes, low iron can definitely cause headaches and even migraines. You know, there's studies now showing that migraine headaches are associated with low iron levels and iron deficiency anemia. And this is because iron affects oxygen transfer. It affects electron transport, storage, and transport. The neurotransmitters need iron for metabolism, like serotonin, norepinephrine, dopamine. DNA synthesis is required. You have to have enough iron to synthesize proper DNA. You know, and there's a host of other energy-related processes that need iron. And there are many, many theories out there as to, you know, exactly why, what's the mechanism, what's the underlying thing, why iron deficiency leads to headaches. It's not totally elucidated yet, but one thing we know is that, or is suggested, is given the role of iron in carrying oxygen on the red blood cell, that, you know, if you have a lack of oxygen available in the brain, that actually leads to swelling of the blood vessels. And that increased pressure because of the swelling can actually produce a headache. Just like, you know, caffeine withdrawals can produce headaches from changes in vascular dilation or constriction. Another theory has to do with iron's role in the upregulation and downregulation serotonin metabolism. So kind of depending on your age, sex, genetic factors, iron deficiency or enough iron may cause serotonin to be made very efficiently, or it may slow down serotonin production. And if serotonin goes up or down, headaches are a common symptom. And this can be, you know, many people also when they're iron deficient, you know, they struggle with motivation, anxiety, depression, And even beyond just the physical fatigue, you know, they actually have these mental, emotional symptoms showing up. And that could be directly related to these effects on serotonin. Or on top of that, glutamate, you may have heard of like MSG causing, you know, headaches and migraines and that kind of stuff. Well, brain glutamate levels are elevated in a state of iron deficiency, which can lead to this basically this hyper excitatory state in the brain, which may possibly manifest as anxiety or panic attacks and headaches or even migraines. So these neurotransmitters, their metabolism is very tightly married to iron availability. And, you know, you may have experienced or heard of low iron levels in friends or family, you know, complaining about like low brain fog. You may have had brain fog if you had your iron levels low previously. And this is super common when I have a patient who's low in iron. And this is hypothesized to be related to the fact that GABA levels are really elevated in some crucial areas of the brain related to thinking processes. So when iron is deficient, essentially this heightened GABA level in these particular areas basically tells the brain, hey, you know what? It's time to turn things down. Let's slow down this neuronal transmission because we do not have enough energy around. So we're just gonna like taper this person down. And you know, so it literally is, it's not just like my brain's sluggish, my brain's not, I feel like I got brain fog. Yes, you have brain fog from iron deficiency, but you know, that sluggishness, it literally is the brain's response to low iron saying, hey, let's slow life down for this person. All right, I hope this helps. Please be sure to share this with your friends, your family, because iron deficiency anemia is a big deal. And 2 billion people on the planet have it, and they can be easily taken care of. And you know, get their life rolling again and get their iron levels and their brain optimized. So get your ferritin levels checked, your iron levels checked, get your total iron binding capacity checked, get a CBC done, make sure things are right for you. I'm Dr. Matt. Please like, share this with your friends and family. You know, given that iron deficiency is the number one nutrient deficiency on the planet, it's safe to say, if you don't, potentially your friend, your family, your children, even your grandparents may be suffering completely needlessly, and you can help. Talk to you later.